Hi guys, this is Ranjit, and in this video, let's have a look at the Samsung Freestyle projector. And as you can see, this is a compact portable projector, but also a smart speaker. And I have been actually testing this for the last 10 days. And I have to say, this is a pretty interesting lifestyle product, or a portable, projector. So let's have a closer look at this one now. So guys, this is the actual Freestyle, and if you notice how small and compact this is. This is the Galaxy S22 smartphone, and as you can see, if I just start it from here, it's almost just the size of that one. That's why it's actually pretty portable. And this is the entire projector itself. In fact, it also has a built-in speaker. You can use it with Alexa or Bixby. If you notice, at the bottom we have the speaker, and in fact we also have some extra ports for smart connectors that will be sold separately. So that's what we have. And this is just a covering. You can just remove it, and you can also use it for the ambient mode. And here is the projector itself. And you also have some touch buttons over here, but you don't have to actually use this one because you get a fully functional remote with this one, as you can see. And this is actually pretty compact. And I like the fact that this is also having Type-C port to charge it, so you can charge it easily. And this is fully functional, so you operate the entire projector directly from this one, and it's pretty slim. If you come back to the projector, in terms of connectivity, if you notice over here, we have a dedicated mic switch because it has that always listening for Alexa and Bixby. You can shut it off and on. You also have a micro HDMI port, so if you want to give inputs, you can actually do that. And we also have a Type-C port and an adapter. In fact, it connects via power delivery, a Type-C port. So you can use the supplied, charger, or even if you have a, modern laptop, most of them are supporting power delivery, so you can use that. So I like that it's using the Type-C port with power delivery. So connectivity is actually really good. And another thing to note is that, again, you can just move it here on the stand. The stand comes built in, so you can just align it. And the best part about this projector is that it does that auto aligning and stuff. I'll actually show you that. So in terms of physical overview, as you can see, it's pretty compact, so you can actually carry this around. In fact, Samsung is going to sell a separate accessory case for this one also. So pretty compact in that aspect. But now let me actually give you actual usage demo of this projector. And guys, I don't know the exact pricing of this product as of now. It will be launching soon in India. So for the exact pricing and if any offers, etc., I'll leave the link of Samsung website in the description. So do check that out. But now let's have a look at this product and how am I actually using the same. This is my home portable office. And if you notice, there is hardly any space here to put up a TV. So I have just an empty wall over here, and I have kept the Freestyle projector here. I'll switch it on with this remote controller, and it has a built-in speaker. I'll show you that. And I'm just using this wall. I'll adjust it, and instantly it came. I'll just adjust this, and I'm actually using this one. Let me just put this and we'll have a look at this one now. Here's the projector, guys, and I like the fact that it auto adjusts the stuff if I move the projector. And this is on the wall over here, as I've told you. And the interface is very similar to Samsung smart TVs. If you noticed, it's very similar to that. In fact, this also has the Samsung TV Plus and all those things. So any spare wall that you have now can be used as a portable TV. In fact, it also has a built-in speaker. Let me actually play some copyright free music. I'm just using YouTube, guys. If you have used any Samsung smart TV, the interface is almost exactly like that. I'll just search for copyright free music. Copyright free music. And the voice command also works. So I just use the voice. So I'll just use this to give you an idea about the sound, built-in sound. Of course, you can pair it with a Bluetooth speaker or whatever. Let me just skip. And notice the quality of the video. It has a built-in speaker and it's adequately loud. I wouldn't say it's the loudest, but if you want even more louder stuff, you can connect Bluetooth speakers and stuff for this one. But for just watching personally, I actually did not have any issues with this one. In fact, let me just play back one of my own videos.
Hi guys, this is Ranjit, and in this
and this should give you an idea about the video quality.
Have a first look at the Samsung Galaxy A53's smartphone.
Let me just go back and let's just search again. I'm going to use this voice search. You just press this, go over here, press this button. 4K videos, and let's play this Costa Rica. I know the quality is good. And though the projector is not 4K, but it's a 1080p projector, just notice the video quality. I hope my camera is able to do justice. In fact, I like the picture quality on this one. This actually screen ranges from 32 inches all the way to 100. I won't stretch it personally to 100, but up to about 60 to 70 inches, the quality is pretty good. And of course, it's a projector because I can come. But notice, I was also pretty happy with the image quality I was getting on this one. So let's just get out of this one. I was not expecting that the colors will be this vibrant, so that's actually a nice thing. And let's look at the interface. Again, as I've told you, this is like a complete Samsung TV interface. You have Amazon Prime, you have Netflix and all those things, and it works. In fact, I've been using, I've watched some movies on Netflix via this one, and it works brilliantly. I was liking what you get with this one. And it's and the interface is pretty responsive for on this one. Again, typical interface. Again, if you have used any Samsung TV, modern smart TV, the interface is very good. Again, give you an idea.
Six-stage meltdown from inside the Hydro Rig's core.
So let me just get out of that. Let's just go back to home. And again, you have apps also. You can install more apps like a smart TV on this one. So you have the Samsung App Store. So from here, you can install popular apps that you want. I didn't install Z, Sony Live, etc. are also there on this one. Let's just go back. And I also like the fact that if you go to the menus, here you have all the settings. Of course, it's working over Wi-Fi. You also have Keystone. That is, again, if you have used any projector earlier, you might have noticed this auto aligned directly like this. I didn't have to do, otherwise it is crooked or something. This one does a very good job, but you can go over here and fine tune it if you want. The same thing is also regarding the focusing. Focusing also, it does automatically, and auto actually does a pretty good job. Again, this is Samsung Life TV or whatever it has, but let's just go back to the settings menu over here, and manually also you can adjust the focus and all those things. 95% of the time it does it automatically, but you can do it, and you also have the scaling option also. By default it does it fine, and you also have picture modes and all those things. Let's just go back to all settings. And if you notice, again, similar settings that you get on a Samsung TV, dynamic mode, all those things. And if you go to expert settings, you get a lot of options just like a traditional TV. I actually disabled this picture clarity settings. I got the best result, so you can play with this one. This projector, as you can see, I'm in my living room. Any wall just becomes a projection, and this wall is actually not white. Let me just switch on a little bit of light so that you can get an idea. This is not white, but then also you can actually use it. So that way, I would say this is a little bit more flexible, and I like the fact that you don't have to do too much adjustments. We just adjust the projector and it actually auto aligns stuff automatically. So that way, I would say the auto alignment and stuff works really well on this projector, because generally what happens is many of the projectors, as you can see, just auto aligned automatically. You have to do that manually, but here this is done automatically. And again, any white wall, you can use it. As you can see, I'm putting it on the top like that. So any wall, empty wall that you have, now you have it for projection. So it's up to your creator. Let me just maximize to give you an idea. As you can see, so any wall that you have, spare wall, can be now used, and as you can see, it auto aligned automatically. So I like that auto correction, auto keystone stuff that we have on this one. Again, another thing is that it has a built-in smart speaker functionality. You can use it with Bixby or even with Alexa. Alexa, you can use it also like an Alexa smart speaker if you want. I used the word, that's why it came. Cancel. Another thing that we have is ambient mode on this one. And again, you can have stuff like this, just displaying. You don't want to display picture or a TV or something. You can just display something like this on this one. Let's say, you want to just say cheers. So yeah. In fact, you also have some scenes, maybe depending on this one. The sunset one looks actually pretty cool. And yeah. As you can see, you can tweak a little bit of setting, so you can have a virtual wall kind of a setting also. So let's say you don't want to play any content, but just want to have, you always had a white wall which you wanted to put out something. So again, you can use this ambient mode also with this one. So guys, this was the Samsung Freestyle projector. Certainly a compact projector. This is kind of a lifestyle product because there is that premium towards this. But I would say this was one of the most interesting tech product that I had tested recently. In fact, I get a lot of tech products and my family generally does not use it. But this one got used quite a bit. In fact, in my office, as you can saw earlier, I used it quite a bit because of that spare wall that I had. In fact, my daughter also use this quite a bit. So certainly a pretty interesting product, and I'm actually looking forward to the next version of this Freestyle projector, maybe the Freestyle Plus or the Pro, what Samsung does with this one. Anyways guys, that's it for now for this video. I'll leave the links in the description so that you can check out and get more info regarding this product. Anyways guys, that's it for now. Thanks for watching. This is Ranjit, and I hope to see you in my next video. Take care guys.